Hi guys, it's me, Ranger Jones again, and welcome to the second part of my tour at the Wieringermeer wind turbine test site in the Netherlands. In my last video, I focused on the E160 EP5, and in this video, I'm going to introduce you to another prototype, which is even larger than the E160 EP5 by General Electric and its new Cypress platform, the G6.0-164. So now I'm with General Electric's prototype, the G6.0-164, 6 megawatts, rotor diameter 164 meters, hub height 120 meters, I believe. That's currently G's largest turbine in its portfolio. It's even bigger than the Enercon E160 EP5. Yeah, so the G6.0 is an upgrade to G's existing Cypress turbines 4.8, 5.3, and 5.5, 158. This turbine has 6 megawatts. So what I believe they did is, instead of building another prototype similar to Enercon, they just upgraded the existing prototype on the site and exchange the gearbox and also exchange the blades. The blades are a little bit longer now. So that again saves time and fastens the process to start testing the turbine. The turbine is actually quite popular in Germany right now. You see many projects using this turbine right now. The 5.3 version as well as the 5.5 version. There are also a few videos on my channel that you can check out of the G5.3. However, I've never actually seen it in operation, so this is really a highlight today to see this giant in operation. Last time I was here in September 2020, when this G5.3 was still on the site, I didn't see it spinning, unfortunately. The blades were down, the hub was down, and I believe they were doing a gearbox exchange. I'm not entirely sure, but I believe the 6.0 prototype was just built here earlier this year, so it hasn't been running for that long. Yeah, when G first came out with this design, I was a little shocked and I thought, oh my gosh, this just looks like a huge ship container, which it does, but the design has kind of grown on me just because of the sheer size of it and the dimensions. It's just really, really impressive. And what I really like about this one, it has really bright obstruction lights. That's really cool. Ah, it just looks really, really elegant and majestic when it spins. Yeah, so this prototype just has a hub height of 120 meters. I've also seen them on 161 meters. That's even more impressive to have a turbine with 160 meter hub height and almost 160 meters rotor diameter. That's really, really cool. All right, I'm gonna try to get a little closer and have a look at it from up close. All right, guys, so now I'm standing right underneath the Cypress turbine
And you need to check this out because this is amazing. Look how low the blade tips are coming down. That's amazing. And that rotor diameter is so massive. Gosh. I'm gagging. This is awesome. Wow. It's actually running pretty quietly, quite smoothly. You can see the huge nacelle from below. Pretty cool. Oh wow, I've been looking forward to this. This is awesome. Yeah, I think I mentioned it before. That Anacon is going more towards using blades that are in one part, and G is doing the opposite. They're dividing their blades into two. I don't know if you can see that, but you can actually see the division of the plates quite well. Ah, I don't think you can see it. It's too fast. But you can see the crack quite well where the blades are divided. So the longer part is actually the front part, and then the shorter part is just the blade tip. I've actually seen the nacelle up close in one of my videos. You can check it out. And it's really got the size of a three-story building. It's huge. Compared to the compact nacelles of Anacon, it's really massive. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. Here you have another great view on the other prototypes. There is the E138. And then the E160 behind it. It actually looks quite funny because the nacelle is so small and then the large rotor diameter, it looks kind of funny. Yeah, I definitely need to go back to the wind farm back home and check out the Cypress turbines there. See them running, because I've never actually seen them in operation. Only seen the construction, but never seen them in operation, so that's a premiere for me. So now I'm standing in front of it. From here you can see the nacelle a little bit better and the rotor. Haha, this is awesome. What's really quite funny though is there is this cable that's connecting the hub to the nacelle that's kind of flopping around. We'll see that later on the drone video. So I'm kind of curious what that is. Cause that doesn't seem right. That seems kind of cheap. You can write in the comments if you know what it is. Wow. Maybe from here you can see the blade division a little bit better. Ah, but I think it's too fast. You need to pause it and then you can see it. Tower is actually quite slender. It's not that tall, it's just 120 meters. So the turbines back home, they have 40 meters more. Because in the lower mountain ranges, you always go for the highest tower. It doesn't make sense to build turbines with that low of a tower. But this site is pretty close to the sea, so you can go with the lower towers. From here you have another great view on the Cypress turbine from the backside. It's just so impressive. Rotor diameter is just so huge. I'm really amazed. And from here you also have another great view on all of the other turbines on the test site. There's the E138 right next to it, the E160, the Vestas turbines, and then the other prototypes are in the row behind that. There's the G130, and then the Vestas turbines next to that, that I'm gonna introduce you to in my next video. And it's just amazing, just like the amount of wind turbines in the background is just so impressive. So many of them. Well, I'm going to keep it short at this point. I'm running low on battery. I hope you guys liked this video. If so, please give me a thumbs up. I'm excited for your comments. What do you think about the G Cypress? Don't forget to subscribe to my channel to see the other turbines in my upcoming videos. Alright you guys, I hope to see you again in the next video. Following now is another short drone video of the G from above. Really, really cool shots, so you can be excited for that. Take care, you guys, and I hope to see you guys in the next video. Bye!